This is Tim Kanak with Perkins Roofing, and today we're going to be talking about what is included in a re-roof quote. So when we're quoting the re-roof, what is included in the main price, and then what is not, and what would be an additional line item. We have protection here for our dumping equipment. We include this in the price, just basic protection. Enhanced protection, like covering a pool, is usually an additional amount. Some other contractors include different things. Right here, the drip metal, which is that white trim metal, that is included in being replaced in the re-roof quote. See, it goes around the entire house. Now the wood behind the drip metal, you can see underneath here, there's a piece of 1x2 wood nailer that separates the drip metal from the fascia. This is the fascia wood. The underneath of the overhang is called a soffit. This is a plastered soffit. Sometimes it's wood or metal. So, or stucco even. Right here, the fascia wood. Changing this out is not included. So we include an X amount of feet of decking wood, but not the fascia wood. This is a pretty normal residential house. It's not really anything crazy with this house. You can see the guys behind me as we're doing the demo. They're taking off the wood. All the layers of the roofing are included in the main price. Should be obvious, right? So the layers of the roofing are included. The wood replacement is only included up to X amount of feet or X amount of sheets of plywood. Any roofing contract will tell you how much wood is included. And if you go over that limit, how much it is to change per foot or per sheet of plywood. Now you see right here, every roof has these vents on it, some sort of ventilation. They're usually for bathrooms or kitchen ventilation. Sometimes we'll have attic ventilation on the roof if they don't have soffit screens in the soffit for the attic to breathe out so it doesn't get humid in the attic, especially here in Florida. So you can see here, that's a 4-inch stack. It's gonna be replaced with a lead stack like that. These are included in the roofing project. They're not additional line items like extra wood. So that's something that's included. Right here, this is a valley. We have valley metal that is included in the contract. Any good roofer will include their valley metal in the contract. In addition, I'm gonna show you another detail here. This is where the power lines from FPL are coming in to the home, and you see a pitch pan right here. Changing out this pitch pan is something that gets included in the re-roof price. It's not an additional line item. Now, something like taking down a satellite dish, which is done sometimes, would be additional. And then changing out little flashings like this in this return with either valley metal or an L metal is also something that is included in the roofing price. Now let's go over here to the flat roof and I'll show you some more details. Here on the flat roof, you can clearly see here's the decking wood. This is 1x6. And then here, there's actually two wood nailers. We got a double wood nailer here, probably because of the gutters. Talking about the gutters here and the downspouts, which the downspouts are the part of the gutter that leads the water down to the ground, are items that are not included. So gutters and downspouts are not included in the roof. These are always additional line items. Some roofing contractors don't even do gutters. We do both gutters and downspouts. So you can always call us to replace those when we do the roof, which is the ideal time. The wood nailer is an additional item. This is not included in re-roofing, but if it needs to be replaced, it would be X amount of dollars per foot of wood nailer to be changed out, just like the decking wood. So we have two different size decking woods here. That's why you have different pricing on different types of wood. Because this is 1x8, and then this is 1x6 on the flat roof here. See, the sloped roof is 1x8. Here is 1x6. So here was a piece of L metal. Changing L metal out, which is like a piece right here that'll come up here, is something that is included in the roof. Sometimes on a flat roof, let's say this roof is higher up, the L metal wouldn't reach all the way to the top. So you'd have an L metal and then a termination bar and a counter flashing. If we had that, usually the counter flashing to replace is an additional cost. So we do charge to replace counter flashing because usually it's embedded within the stucco and the stucco has to be cut and replaced for the stucco metal to be installed. Watching, if you have any questions about what should be included on a residential roof, if you want to make sure that you have everything included on your residential roof quote, or if you want us to quote your roof for you if you're in South Florida, anywhere from Port St. Lucie down to the Keys, give us a call, Perkins Roofing, 305 MIA Roof. And you can comment on the video if you have questions. If you're not in our territory and you want some help, I'm always happy to help. So please reach out with any questions and we'll get into the commercial side. We've seen a residential re-roof and what's included in a residential re-roof. Let's check out a couple commercial roofs behind me and see what's included in a re-roof of commercial buildings. But commercial roofs are completely different when it comes to re-roofs. There are all kinds of features that are not included in the main roof. Like you can see, I am currently on a flat roof, especially flat roofs. You see I'm on a flat roof. I'll show some drone photos so you can see the shape of the roof. But the flat roof here, all of the papers for the flat roof are included in the roof. And different types of sloping can be done on the flat roof. Usually that sloping will be included, but there can be upgrade options. For instance, the manager for this building has asked me for 1/8 inch slope, which is the minimum for re-roof per code in South Florida, with the option to upgrade to a 1/4 inch slope. So when that happens, the main slope would be 1/4 inch and the crickets would be 1/2 inch crickets. So crickets are like little areas that slope things away from buildings or little like vents and stuff like that. Now I'm going to show you some of these details so we can see what else is on this roof. All of these penetrations in the roof, a penetration is anything that sticks out of the roof. You see we have vents here, we have racks for mechanical, for AC stuff, HVAC. We have vents here, big vents. We have little fire mains here. We have scuppers, copings. So basically all of these items here, these penetrations are all gonna be something that gets included in the main roof price. So all these penetrations are gonna be included. Now, replacing the actual vent would not be included. Or replacing the actual HVAC equipment like the racks or the ducts will not be included. Only the flashing. So basically, this right here is going to be included. This little umbrella flashing split pipe. This vent here, only this flashing metal will be included, but not the replacement of the actual vent. These vents here, the lead stacks, they will be replaced. That is something that gets included in the re-roof. Additional item that is not included in the roof is this detail here. This is called a coping cap. On top of the parapet wall, this protects the wall from water coming in through the cap of the wall and getting underneath the roofing system, which will happen if this is not installed. So this is an additional line item because the normal termination for a roof comes up the wall 8 inches. So our normal termination, you can see here's 8 inches. That right here would come up the roof with a termination bar and a stucco stop metal. And then this would just be exposed stucco. But this detail for this roof calls for a coping cap, which is an additional line item. And this one is going to be stainless steel on top of it. As you can see, we're on the water here. So all of the metals on this roof are stainless steel, which is also an additional item. Usually we use galvanized steel for our flashings, for our metal flashings on the roof. I'll show you the difference between the parapet wall coping cap that's behind me here. That's a 9-inch coping cap, which is standard, and the standard termination detail, which is right here. See here is the stucco stop metal. It's a stainless steel stucco stop. It's riveted into the wall here, anchored into the wall with wall attachment anchors. And underneath this is something called a termination bar. So this is the standard detail on the roof, whereas the coping cap that we have on the walls on the perimeter, that is an upgrade option.
On these middle areas, we have stainless steel stucco stop metal and on these ducts. And then we also have stainless steel 4x4 drip metal. This is 4x4. On here, up there, that's all 4x4 drip. And then even the door thresholds have like a custom stainless steel threshold. I'm gonna get the measurement on. Rehash, these vents, like the lead stacks, are all items that are included. These flashings here, these are upgraded flashings. These, the normal ones are like this, chem curbs. These are stainless steel split boot flashings. Those are included at an additional price since it's an upgrade item. And then things like this, the flashing, are included. Usually the vents would not be. See how fly roofs can get kind of expensive with all the additional items you have to include? Like, look at all these penetrations for all these pipes behind me. All these are more money. Ka-ching, 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 ka-ching. All of this linear footage of coping cap. Ka-ching, 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 ka-ching. All of the sloping that has to go in here under the roof because the concrete deck is flat. Ka-ching, ka-ching. All of the vents. Ka-ching, ka-ching, ka-ching. It all adds up. And some of this stuff like this is not even for code because it has to be an inch and a half off the ground. So there is a lot of stuff here that gets added into the contract on some of these commercial roofs, especially the commercial flat roofs like this one. That's included, but is an additional item on the contract, a line item, is going to be drainage. Like right here, you see this is a scupper. There are no overflow scuppers on this roof. Technically, per code, there should be field drains and then overflow drains. All we have here are field drains in the field, the retrofit drains. Those are the drains that are in the center of the roof. And then these ones here on the walls are called scuppers. So these scuppers right here, there should be overflow scuppers, which come up 2 inches. You see, this is straight into the actual roof. There's no overflow. So when I walk around on this roof, you can see, like right behind me here, you see this right here? That's a field drain because it's in the middle. It's in the field of the roof. See, here's our field drain. And a retrofit field drain would be, we're going to put a new bowl in, into the existing bowl, and basically it's gonna shrink the size of the roof drain that is there. And then here, these are the scupper drains, but you can see they're all field. None of them are raised 2 inches, so there's no overflow on this roof. So they're gonna have to add overflows per code. Usually picture framing these scuppers, that's it, usually an additional line item to do something like that. So that's not something that's usually included in a commercial fly roof. You can see that the actual drain is 4 inches wide. So it could be retrofitted into 3 inches if they decide that they wanna retrofit these instead of putting new bowls in, because you can see that these rings are pretty old at the field drains.
You always have to do when re-roofing a fly roof is you've got to do a core test to check how deep the ISO is, because the thickness of that insulation, like this roof is 5 inches, is going to adjust the price to a considerable amount. And you also have to check to see what kind of roofing system was there before. This is a 4-ply system. It's a very thick system, very good roof that's here right now. I've been recommending to restore it rather than re-roof it, but the insurance is making them re-roof. So if they want to replace this kind of roof, it's going to be pretty penny per square foot. What is included on a residential versus a commercial re-roof? And for more information, you can contact us at MIA 305 MIA Roof, or find us online, perkinsroofing.net, or you can comment on the videos on YouTube. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on all of our social medias. We're happy to help with anyone even who's not even in South Florida, who's not in our network. We are happy to help. And there are other items that we didn't see on these buildings or on the residentials, like skylights and stuff like that, that would not be included in a normal roof contract. If you have questions about that, just give us a holler. Thanks for watching.